On the 1st of September 1940, a legend was born in Port Harcourt, Rivers State, to an Igbo father, Chief Moses Maduka Nwachukwu of Umudinja, Ovim, in Isukwato local government area of Abia State, and an Hausa Fulani mother, Haji Yabina Fatima Mohammed Diko of the ruling family of Katsina in Katsina State. That legend is Senator General Ike Nwachukwu, an administrator par excellence, an international statesman, a nationalist, an accomplished soldier, a diplomat par excellence, a political colossus, quintessential leader, and a God-fearing father. He's married to Gwendolyn Tonesia Yonyisola Ejiwumi of Ofada, Abeokuta in Ogun State, whose mother comes from the Bob Manuel ruling home of Abonema in Rivers State. Hence, he's called The Bridge. Nwachukwu had his early education at Ladilac Institute and Lagos City College, all in Yaba, Lagos State. He obtained military training at the Nigeria Military Training College, Kaduna, at the Royal Canadian School of Infantry, Canada, School Infantry, Warminster, United Kingdom. He had further studies at the Institute of Humanitarian Law, San Remo, Italy, the United Nations Peace Academy, and the National Institute for Policy and Strategic Studies, Kuru, in Plateau State. He rose to the rank of Major General prior to his retirement with the Nigerian Army, having served meritoriously. Senator General Ike Nwachukwu was the military governor of Old Imo State between 1984 and 1985. From 1986 to 1987, General Nwachukwu was Minister of Employment, Labor and Productivity, where he founded the National Directorate of Employment to alleviate the problems of unemployment, especially among graduates. Nwachukwu was a two-time Minister of Ministry of Foreign Affairs between December 1987 and December 1989. As the world celebrates this consummate general today, we reached out to some of his close friends to learn more about this great personality. We spoke to the former Assistant Director General in Charge of Operations, DSS, Chief Ray Nkemderim, and the former Commissioner in Abia State, Henry Agbeze. They spoke on why the General, Ike Nwachukwu, was regarded as the bridge in contemporary Nigeria.
Well, the General is someone who made very deep impact on those of us in our generation who grew up, get to learn about him for the first time when he became military governor of the old Imo State. As young men, we're very proud of him, his courage, his intellect, his vision. For most of us as young men, we aspired to be like him, and we followed his trajectory along the path of his rise to greatness. He was Minister of War, he was Minister of Foreign Affairs, and his record in the military, indeed, is someone that you would want to emulate, and pray God that you follow in his footsteps.
Senator Ike Nwachukwu's life can be summarized in area of service to humanity. He's a very selfless man, a man who is people-centric. He always try to make sure there's fairness, justice, and equity to all, irrespective of sex, race, tribe, or creed. He's a man of character, a man who respects everyone, irrespective of their position, high, lowly, or highly placed. Senator Ike Nwachukwu has brought a lot of succor to us. You know, he was the brain behind the creation of Abia State in 1991 as a member of Armed Forces Ruling Council. He saw to it that those that serve in Nigerian Army were reintegrated into the mainstream of Nigerian Army.
Isukwato, the country home of Senator Ike Nwachukwu, is known as the land of generals, given the array of senior officers the area has produced in both military and other security outfits. So we tried to find out how his career success inspired the massive interest of Isukwato indigenes in military and paramilitary services.
Oh, of course. When they say Isukwato is the land of generals, we're talking of people like him, people like General Ejirika, people like Godwin Ndubisi Kanu, and a host of others, AIG Iroham, and of course my humble self in the Department of state services. Sukwato is a land that is replete with sons and daughters who have made their mark in the security sector of this country. And Ikewachukwu stands out.
In Sukwato, you have two former military governors. They are alive. We have the fourth chief of army staff in the southeast after General Agirunsi is General Ihejirika, who is also a cousin to General Ikewachukwu. There are other generals in Sukwato, both in the Air Force and the Navy. We have people like Air Vice Marshal Onyike. We have people like Granya Lechi. We have Navy Captain Orson, the former military governor. And so many of them that are there, many generals. In the DSS, we have one of the best brain and outstanding disciplined career man, Chief Ray Nkendrim. Ray was also a quintessential civil servant, so to say. A well-trained, intelligent, a consummate administrator as a director in SS. And Ike was their reference point. He was like their beacon. He was like their mentor.
What can the younger generation learn from the life of Senator General Ike Nwachukwu?
He is a very cool and calculating gentleman. He avoids controversy or remains focused in whatever he has set out to achieve for himself. In the political terrain, when he bestrode that sector, he was called the bridge. He is a quintessence of what a Nigerian politician should be, detribalized, and by birth, by marriage, he was well prepared or well positioned to display what indeed it is to be a true Nigerian, and he made the best of it.
He do not overindulge on anything. He's disciplined in his eating habit. He's disciplined in his exercise. He's disciplined in the way he carry himself and duty. Young men today should learn to be moderate, to be disciplined, to have character, because character pays. A man without character is equal to nothing and has no value. General is a man so religious with fear of God.
The governor of Imo State, Ike Nwachukwu, played a leading role in ensuring the success of Sam Mbakwe International Airport in Owerri.
As of 1994-95, when he was governor there, it was only Enugu Airport, not even international, that was in existence in the entire. He gave me feet that there's near Imo, which comprises three states, the current Imo State, Abia, and the part of Ebonyi State, to have an airport. And that is the first people finance airport in Nigeria. Levies and donations were made by Imo indigenous. They contributed to build that Imo cargo airport. It was a cargo airport originally, which is now Sam Mbakwe Airport. The entire old Imo people contributed handsomely to realize that dream of Imo Airport.
General Ike Nwachukwu is a loving and God-fearing father. He's happily married to Chief Mrs. Gwendolyn Toneyesia Nwachukwu, MFR, a retired Federal Permanent Secretary, and the marriage is blessed with four children, namely Ikechukwu Nwachukwu Jr., Chinemerem Diko Nwachukwu, Udochukwu Nwachukwu, now Mrs. Ofonagoro, and Ngozi Nwachukwu.
Well, like the good book says, I'll only wish that his latter days will indeed be greater than the former. That the good Lord will imbue him with good health, more wisdom, and for those of us who are following in his footsteps, we pray that he will continue to remain for us a beacon of hope, a beacon of leadership. And God Almighty will crown all his desires with great success.
The management and staff of Flow 94.9 FM wishes Sir General Ike Nwachukwu a happy birthday.